Hello Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at one of the great classic Lego space spaceship sets. This is the Galaxy Commander from 1983. It came with 443 pieces in the set. Step 1, spaceship. Check out the cool twin cockpit design. It's kind of set up for two equal players in terms of controlling the thing. Nice winglets on the sides. Got a pair of wings in the front, pair of wings in the back. Lots of transparent colored items all around the whole thing. I've got a very large kind of cargo space in the back. You also have a single large communication satellite sort of dish transceiver that's able to go up or that can just stay down during flight. Kind of got a couple of engines kind of tucked in, one here on this side, one over here on this side, and then you got same size, but more of a direct firing one here, and then you've got a couple of little thrusters underneath the thing. It's a very, it's a very nice looking design, very futuristic for its day. I like it. Got a good amount of detail on it. They kind of mix the white and the blue together in a way that is harmonious. It would be easy to make this look like just a big mess. Personally, I think it does not look like just a big mess. But the big deals with this thing really comes in when you start to take it apart. First of all, you can just lift this bit right here, this little part of the rear roof section of the kind of control section of it, and that allows all of the back to just slide out, or all of the front to slide off. That leaves this up front as a spaceship unto itself. So this is really the powered section and the control section, and this is what's able to fly off on its own anytime that you like. You can see that it just has a small little area back here for inserting the whole mechanism to attach the rear section. And this is pretty cool, especially, again, for its day. This was a definite look. The whole twin cockpit thing was most popularized by Star Wars with the Bespin cloud cars in episode 5, Empire Strikes Back, but it's not the only place that you've seen it. It kind of has a little bit of a Galaga kind of look to it, or a lot of those top-down view sort of arcade shooter games had that kind of design. Nice little transparent sections underneath the cockpit so you can see forward. Little bit of asymmetry here with the guns in the front. I'm going to call those guns. Should be pretty safe. You can see they're offset to one side a little bit, and that's because of the little minifigure pieces that are being used for that, but still think it looks pretty good. Cockpits individually open up. There's that one. You can see, just very simple little steering wheel in there. That's all you get. You also have a little place where you can store some stuff right here if you would like. Now that leaves this whole section behind on the surface. It does look like it has a couple of lifting motors to help with either short landings or a little bit of short takeoff. Maybe this thing can hop around a little bit on its own. I think they're mostly just intended to be boosters to help the whole thing to move this large load around. Like this, it's not really going to do too much. You can have minifigures inside of there, and of course, again, you can put this up, but that's pretty much it. It gets more interesting and more useful when you take off these little tile pieces that are on either side. I actually just place them in a place where they're not locked in. Normally they would be going over one of these studs right here, that one. But taking those off unlocks this whole section back here. And unfortunately, this hinge on this side is a little bit tight, but you can see already it's kind of dropping this center section. These slopes interface with these inverted slopes to actually lift the whole thing up. So when you bring these out, it's going to drop it down, and now you can just slide all this forward, move that out of the way, and that leaves this behind. Okay, now I'm going to put this up, and what else can we do here? Open up all of that. There you go. Now you've got your little mobile lab that you have left behind on the surface of the planet that you were exploring. Now that is nice. I really like the blue windows. It really lets the light through there very nicely and just kind of sets the mood. Again, very futuristic, very sci-fi, very appropriate for the time. Even today, I still think that looks kind of kind of good with all the white, and then the blue just looks really good. These are intended to be a couple of tools here. This, I believe, is a plunger, is a deep space plunger for your toilet. If your toilet goes bad, of course, they don't have a toilet in this unit, but maybe in the other piece. I'm pretty sure that's what that's for. Or maybe it's just an antenna. There's a little bed right here. That little flat bit there is, I believe, a bed, or it could be used as a table, but I think that's more just a sleeping arrangement. So that's a nice little thing now. All together, this turns into something very useful on a surface. From the other side, you know, it's not all quite as interesting to look at from the outside. I believe these up here would be RCS thrusters that would be used when the whole thing is all assembled together. But this is a nice little unit that has good details that can be used for many things, and it all folds up nicely too. This thing, this kind of frame that holds it all in, is kind of useless by itself. This is not a very good looking thing. It doesn't really make sense that it would be doing anything in particular. I really think it's just intended to be an adapter to hold all of this together. One other thing I want to show you here is what the ship looks like with just this frame attached, with no lab in the back. That's not a bad look. I'm pretty happy with that until you start looking at it from the back and from the top. I still think that that's an okay look. You know, close these up, get them, again, it's a little bit of a stiff joint over on that side, but that's pretty cool. I like that. I just don't like this thing by itself. One thing is certain though, when it comes to picking this up, this whole motion of just sliding this in kind of lifts itself. Close this up, close this up. That's very slick. Now you're ready to go. These two little land vehicles are included with the set also, or made with the primary build. They're small, they're simple, but they're nice to have. You know, they allow you to take a couple of your minifigs and do some extra things. This one here on the left can be used more as a rover, kind of a general utility vehicle out on the surface of wherever you are, whereas this one here is more of a tender. It's more of a fuel tender because it has this hose, and that hose has a nozzle at the end of it. You can take this and attach it wherever you like onto the ship for refueling, or maybe download some data. You could look at it that way nowadays, especially for downloading data. It does have a pretty fancy little computer screen there. And on the back, it also has an extra spot where you can put some stuff in, some small little things, or you could represent, you know, you could take some little clear, transparent colored parts and put them in there and say that that's fuel or something like that. A landing pad sort of base plate is included with this set. This one here is kind of faded. The yellow color or orangish color is not quite the way that it should be. Also, I don't think this is the correct plate, because there's another version that's actually shown on the package, it'll show in a minute, that I believe is the older version of this that has a little bit more orange, has more of the orange lines around it. It looks very similar to this, but not exactly. Here's the selection of minifigs I got with this set. Though again, this is not exactly correct, because this guy right here has the wrong helmet for that era. Should have been the same as all the rest, but otherwise these guys generally get the idea across. These have really low wear, surprisingly, on the torsos. These are in really fine shape, and you can see that the plastic is not worn down too much. It's not scuffed up too much. It has some nice sheen on it, so these are looking pretty new. Hopefully they have been able to take some time to do some missions and bring some happiness to some kids in the past, but this is the correct ratio of all the different colors. You do get these three colors, including only one of the little red guys. I did not get a complete box with this set, but I got the main panels, the things that really count. So here you can kind of see a little bit better the correct base plate that should be with it. You'll see some of these in my main little layout that I put together, but just a slight little difference on the print there. But more importantly here, this was a flap on the box that you could actually open up like this. So you open that up, and that's showing you just the default build over here on the left, the different versions, how you can take different stuff apart. And there again in the upper right is the default build. And then down at the bottom right, you start to see one of the alternate builds that they suggest. That's a nice little space base, you know? I like that. A little communications center. You still have your two little rovers, slightly different builds, but you end up with more of a small space shuttle, and then kind of a speeder to go around closer to the surface. Now here is the back panel, what would have been the bottom of the box or the back of the box when it was standing up. This has some really cool stuff on it. So let's start with this big picture of what looks to me to be a refueling station. I think that's just what this is. This is basically the space extraterrestrial kind of version of a gas station. And because they have two full cockpits included with this thing, they just rebuilt the main ship into two smaller ships. Very cool. I like that. Also changed up the color scheme on the two rovers. Pretty cool. Don't know what that's supposed to be. That just looks like a weird, funky mishmash. Mishmash? Mitch? Mix? Mac? Bleh. You know, it's weird. This, on the other hand, looks like it makes a lot more sense to me. A proper little elevated platform. It even has a couple of defense cannons on it. Look at that. Those are clearly anti-air cannons that are set up at the edges of this thing. Nice little base. Again, a couple of little ships used there. Really useful pieces. Up here in this corner here, that's an interesting different ship. Again, dual cockpits, separated, but just a very, very different design. I'm assuming that this would leave a lot of parts behind as well, but still, it's very long, and it looks like they've turned all this in the front into more of a cargo section in the front there. So this would open up. This whole thing here is a flap. It's hinged, and all that would open up, and it would kind of be working, I'm assuming, like a freighter of sorts. And you've got this little rover right here, which is just a funny little thing. Three little buddies going around on some dunes on some alien planet. And this really tugs at my heartstrings. I love that design, and you do two of them here. That just looks so good to me. So good in so many ways. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. I want that. Of course, I'm not gonna take apart my fancy big ship to make that right now, but I think I might make something like that in the future. That is too cool. Well, that was thoroughly enjoyable to me. This set definitely has some odd quirks to it, but overall I'm very happy with it. I really like how many different things that you can do with it, and it's just such a great set for taking apart and making into other different things. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed this as well, and I hope that you'll stick around to check out more of my videos. I've got more on my channel, all arranged into playlists. You can search, you can browse, and you can follow everything that I'm up to currently on my blog at JANGBRiCKS.com. Hope to have a chance to talk to you again soon in the next video. Hope that you'll leave a comment if you have any thoughts about this set that you'd like to share with the community, and I'll be talking to you again very soon.